Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. Today we're going to talk about something that's already built into your computer that you might not even be aware of. It's called an on-screen keyboard, and here's how it works. Let's say that you are somebody who has a hard time using the computer keyboard due to troubles with your hands or different kinds of mobility issues that might make it difficult, but you can still use the mouse. And you might be able to use a regular mouse or a trackball or a different kind of mouse that might be controlled by eye movement or maybe even a trackball up under your chin. There are a lot of different kinds of pointing devices out there that rely on different kinds of movement and allow people to use the mouse. And then we can use that mouse to use the keyboard. So if you will look here on my screen, I'm going to click on the Windows Start button. Now I'm using Windows Vista here, but this exists on most versions of Windows. I'm going to click on All Programs, then I'm going to go to Accessories, down to the Ease of Access Center, and click on On-Screen Keyboard. And in just a second here, it's going to load up what looks like a picture of a computer keyboard. It's really a virtual keyboard here that I can move around, position anywhere I want on the screen. And then I can use it to type. So let's fire up Notepad here, which gives me a place to type. Click in Notepad, and then I can point and click at whatever letters I would like on this keyboard to type. And I'm just typing Hi Mom here. Now right now I'm pointing with my finger on the mouse trackball or the trackpad here on the laptop, but I could use any kind of an external mouse to do that. Let's say that I had difficulty with clicking. Moving the mouse around or whatever adaptive mouse I want is okay, but I have a hard time actually doing the click. Well, I can go into the settings menu, go to typing mode, and click on hover to select here. And right now it's set to 1 second. I can change those to different levels of time there. And what happens then is, instead of having to click, all I have to do is just point. And this little thermometer thing fills up, and if I hold the mouse still over a key, it'll fill up and then type for me. So I don't even have to click at this point. All I have to be able to do is move my mouse pointer around and type on different things. So again, if I'm using a trackball mounted under my chin or some sort of a system that makes eye movement translate into a mouse control, that'll let me do that. You can also go in here and change this so that you can make it a little easier to see. Let me turn off my dwell select feature there. You can make the font a little bit bigger, so if that keyboard's a little bit difficult to see, I can increase the font, make it a little bit easier to see. So this works with any program on your computer that uses standard mouse and keyboard kind of input. So you can do word processing or send an email, go to the internet and browse the web. And the idea is, if you can only control a mouse or an alternative mouse, you've got pretty good access to your keyboard. This is just one of many things that Microsoft includes in their operating systems to allow people with disabilities to have an easier time accessing their system. The Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads is Microsoft's Accessibility Resource Center. So we actually provide trainings and do a lot of things on not only the on-screen keyboard, but other kinds of technology that is built into your Microsoft products to help people with disabilities. We'll be doing more tech tips on this in the future and explaining to you how you can use things that are already built into your computer to be more independent. So that's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project in Indiana.